Quentin thought this was Chancy CD to begin with.
100%. It had Chancy written all the fuck over it, man.
I'd have made so much money off of you. You'd have paid me like a rube. I'd have been like, yeah.
I'm just stating. Like,
his circus folk past makes him good at that, but.
How dare you for being prejudiced, sir?
Prejudiced?
It's truth.
I don't know.
I'm not saying it's, you know, I didn't say you were wrong, but it was prejudicial bias. You were like, oh, this is fucking Chancy all day, twice on Sunday.
Well, based on the other pick, yes, 100%. Like, I can't tell you how many times I've heard Jeremy say the whole Big Papa line, you know, like, you know, during other pods and stuff. So I'm just stating that seemed like a very logical Jeremy pick. And then you're out there in fucking God knows what universe. So skull fucking might be okay in your eyes.
I mean, the only difference that I would have on this is that she'd have to actually have the eye removed first. Like, I'm not taking the eye out and then fucking. That's not what I'm doing. Like, if she popped the glass eye out and I stuck the tip in to see how it felt, like, that's a whole ass other thing.
Take two. Cut.
And that right there was our that's the opener. That's the opener.
Oh my god.
That's the fucking opener right there. Oh my god, yeah.
Well, I had a panic disorder, rage, severe depression. On top of all that, I'm stressing. Took a blind date to my therapy session and then tried to kill her. Her first impression was I'm groovy. I need a lumbotomy. Yes. But when I press play, trouble leaves up out of me. Fuck the real world in my fat ass stuck in. Cause in my music, hotties are fucking. Woo! Expression, getting out all I wrote. Depression, ripping out all your throat. And if my hearing was ever to go, mass murder would be inevitable. I'm a...
Welcome to Maniacal Music Musings, where we challenge each other to listen to an album and pick our top five off of it.
That's right. And we even give our reviews of all the CDs.
I'm Jeremy Bryant.
I'm Chancy Grant.
And we are the Maniacal Music Musers. You motherfucker, you didn't tell me we were going to try to do it together for the first time.
I actually forgot about that because I'm sick.
Yeah.
And I totally forgot about that. And I was just like, I was about halfway through it, and I was like, I fucked up.
Our guest this week is another bastard. Supposedly the best bastard, as he says, but I question that daily. And he is Quentin Vandestroot. And I think I said that right, but...
Yeah, actually, that's pretty close, and pretty much everybody else gets it. But hey, what's up, everybody? What's going on?
For all those who know, there's a... I actually had to explain to another podcast last night I was on about what pulling a Q means. Because one of the guys did it, and he's like, oh, I do this every time. I'm like, oh, yeah, we call that pulling a Q. We have a guy that does it every time, too, almost. Q, how you doing today, sir?
I am doing good, actually. You know, looking over what I kind of got here, this is actually going to be very hard for me for the five, my top five. Because I picked a great album for y'all to listen to. So, but other than that, no, I'm doing great, man. You know, living life.
All right, that's good to hear. So, speaking of that album, we will start with that album as we always let our guests go first, as that's the courteous thing to do, and we are not bastards on this show. So, we're just musers.
I'm still a bastard regardless.
Oh, we're still bastards. We just hide it a little better, but
fair enough. I can do that.
So, Q, why don't you go and tell them what album you picked and why you picked it?
Well, I picked the album Wednesday by my man Chris Webby. You ain't never had a friend like me. You ain't never had a friend like me. In it to the end like me. No matter what the end might be. Y'all know me. I hit hard like Apollo Creed. Simply just because I feel like he's extremely underrated. He puts out a song literally every single Wednesday of, you know, every single week. I mean, it actually premieres on like Tuesday night. He's over in Connecticut. That's where he's from. So, I mean, he's just severely underrated and overlooked. I mean, if you actually listen to his lyrics, he's got bars, you know, he does wordplay, you know, like he just switches things up, his flow is everything like that. I mean, dude's got it all. He really does. I mean, if you just give him a chance to listen and don't listen to like his first stuff, which even I thought was actually, I mean, I still thought it was pretty good, but.
Yeah, I was going to say, don't. Let's not lie to ourselves here.
I'm not lying. Those were like the very first songs I heard by him, and that's what got me to be a Chris Webby fan. You got to start somewhere, right? You don't start off great. You get there. So, I mean, but I simply picked the album Wednesday just because there are shit ton of great songs on that entire album. This is the album I like the majority of, like, the songs. I mean, actually, I guess that's most albums. But I'm saying, like, there's only, like, maybe one or two on this album that I really don't care for, as opposed to maybe, like, three or four. But I'm saying, like, this. I thought this was definitely a great album. And I'm actually interested to hear what you guys picked for your five.
Well, I'm going to let Chancy go first because I'm dying to hear this review.
Oh, God. Here we go.
Once, I was literally listening to the first song and he goes, "Webby!" And I was like, I just threw my fucking paper. Just fucking get this garbage out of here. But being the dedicated individual that I am, I forced it down my throat.
Forced it more or less into your ears.
Yeah, well, you know. It had to go somewhere.
Not saying a word there, but yeah.
I did actually go into this as unbiased as I could. I will admit this because I do want to actually try and give the guy a shot. Because, I mean, I Love College was the first fucking song hit I heard, and it was garbage. It was like, I think it was the proximity.
It was better than the Acid Rosh or Roth one. Rosh album.
I won't deny that. I won't argue it. But like, I actually did a poll, some stuff that I related to and enjoyed. At first, I thought it was the album that was making me feel rough. Like, I was listening to it, and I'm just like, there's so many songs on this fucking thing. And, like, the first fucking, like, three or
four. There's only, like, 18.
Only 18. I thought it was 19, but mine had 19. And I was like, shit, all these motherfuckers have all these long-ass songs. Or albums, anyway. Because Jeremy's was a pretty fucking lengthy album as well. Yeah, no, it was rough. It was rough. Not as rough as some, but yeah, that's what I got. I mean, I'm ready to kick it up for my five whenever Q gets done or after. I'll go last. I don't care. But a lot of it was just forcing myself to be like, just fucking listen. Don't.
So your top five are your the ones you can stand the most? Is that what I'm getting from this?
Basically. I mean, the fact that the first, like, three tracks...
How do you not find him good?
I mean, the whole... I was actually getting ready to say that the first three tracks, at least the first three, start off by him saying, "Oh, hell, I hope I didn't do the deluxe edition again." I probably did.
Is that Jamie? I'm guessing, but
I probably did do the extended edition. I did almost commit a sacrilege because when I was trying to go for my top five and mine, nice.
Funny.
I was listening to the edited album and I was like, "What the fuck is this? Get off! Get out of here!"
Ready. Say
Frederick, what's up?
Knew you wanted to say that. Yeah, it's gonna be a big fuck you coming next, I'm sure.
Oh, I know, I can't wait.
Well, Sir Chancy, does that
Yep, that sums up my feelings about this album.
Well, going into this album, because of the brackets we've done in the past with music, I was like, oh, God. I said to Chancy last week, I'm like, I guarantee it's going to be Chris Webby. I guarantee it's going to be Chris Webby. And I was right, but I was almost pleasantly surprised listening to this CD because, I mean, I didn't get to really give him a chance during the 2000s music bracket on Bracket Bastards because he wasn't on Spotify for those songs. So I wasn't going to go, I didn't have time to go to YouTube while I'm driving and try to listen to shit. So, but listening to this CD, I was pleasantly surprised at how much I actually enjoyed some of the songs. And we'll get into it, but he does remind me of a few different rappers, which I'll get into with some of my top five. But overall, I was pleasantly surprised, and it wasn't a letdown like a grin in your face over there. But
that's fucking great. So, all right, you know, at least Jeremy's got some fucking taste. I mean, which is kind of surprising coming from your album that you picked. That I swore I would have put money on it that it was Chancy's.
I would have gladly accepted your bet too. I've been like, oh yeah, that was yeah, dude. I'll fucking bet you $50 right fucking now.
Well, like what I'm saying though is like a Biggie seems to be more of a Jeremy pick.
I don't know.
Well, we'll get into that. Does. We'll get into that when we get to Chancy CD. I promise you that. But because I no hate. I respect Biggie, but we'll get into it. But Q, it's time for you to give us your top five off your CD. All
right, my top five is definitely Rookie of the Year, Dazed and Confused, Stick Up, Twist Again, and Weirdo. I may have named six. I'm not really sure there.
I'm pretty sure I counted five, but I don't know.
So as well.
Maybe Freddy's counting abilities are rubbing off on me, but. But
yeah, 11. Oh my god.
But yeah, I. It's funny because a few years do match up with mine as well, but okay. And I'll give my top five first since Chancy gave his review first. So, and okay, well, first things first. Did you have any honorable mentions, or are you gonna pull a Jeremy and just say the rest of the CD is an honorable mention?
An honorable mention.
Yeah, like.
Like when you pick top five of something, you can when you pick a top five of anything, like on other shows that I've been on, you always can pick honorable mentions as well because it's just there could be more than five things on five TV shows or five movies or five.
Oh, okay.
Songs.
So you mean like another song that's on the album that I really like that just didn't make the top five?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Oh, okay. Raw Thoughts, definitely. Raw Thoughts is funny as fuck.
All right. Well, then you just definitely. You hit another one on my list then. But, well, let me do my top five then to sum this up. And my honorable mention, I had one honorable mention for this CD, and it was Friend Like Me.
Fair enough. Yes. Definitely.
I got that one.
Just because I did dig it, and I did like, I did kind of see it for like the Disney movie song it is too.
Oh, yeah. He does that on a lot of songs. Like, there's a song called, Arabian Nights.
Yeah, that's not on my list.
Though. It's not, no, it's not on this album. It's on his, it's one of his, like, singles or his newer albums. But, that song is really good, too. And it keeps the whole, like, you know, like, desert, you know, like, Arab, like, vibe and stuff through the entire song.
Yeah, maybe I will check that out someday. Maybe. I got a lot of music to listen to with this show, so.
Most definitely.
But my number five was Middle Ground.
Middle Ground, that's a good one, definitely. I would put that up there for sure.
Another one off my list.
Number four is Nightcrawler, because I did like that it had, like, comic book references in it and all that, too. But how the fuck you gonna name a song Nightcrawler and not mention the actual Nightcrawler from comic books when you're mentioning Spider-Man shit? I mean, come on. If you're gonna mention like Spider-Man and other superheroes and the song is called Nightcrawler, it pretty seems like simple math. But
I actually really like Nightcrawler, especially the one where he's talking about having to have a like a garlic necklace, a crucifix, silver bullets with extended clips. Like, to me, that fucking line is funny, and it's kind of factual if you go off of the whole like vampire and, you know, like night stuff.
Yeah, which I did hear that. I did like it. My whole house is shook, and I don't know why, but that was weird. But hopefully everybody's okay. We'll find out later. But
the podcast is more important. Keep the pod going.
Always. Pot or die. But my number three was Dazed and Confused, because I had to enjoy the song about taking drugs.
Right? You have to, right?
And I've already mentioned dropping acid in it, because I did do that one night, and it was very much being dazed and confused and blacked out for moments of time. But
good
night. Now, number two is when I get into these songs, I'm like, okay, these are reminding me of other things. Raw Thoughts, to me, sounded like a Hobson and
Girl Mind. That's exactly what it is, yes. It's just Chris Webby's version.
It's like Hobson and Mad Child combined in different parts. Like, I can hear Hobson's lyrics, and I can hear Mad Child's flow, kind of.
Hobson's, no. Okay, I like Hobson, but no. Dude, no. No. Fuck, hey, no.
Freddie loves Mad Child, because I got him into it. But
he loves Tom McDonald, too, but, I mean, nothing against Tom. Nothing against Tom. But I'm just saying, like, he's be at best. Be at best.
Well, we already discussed Tom McDonald in this show once, and I think Chancy agreed with you on that. But
I give him a B for the effort.
I like his planning.
Freddy's
McDonald before you, or McDonald before you? What? Yeah, Mad Child. Wow. No.
Yeah, but all right. So my number one was, of course, Weirdo, which I'm like, Q picked the CD because of this fucking song for me, I'm pretty sure. But so yeah, and it reminds me of a G-Mo Ski song, kind of.
A what song?
G-Mo Ski.
G-Mo Ski. I don't think I remember who that is.
Yes, Jamie, we know Mad Child's been on your radar because you think he's hot, but I posted a picture of young Mad Child in group one day, and Jamie was like, damn. But
it's like, damn.
But yeah, so G-Mo Ski will be on the show eventually at some point, and I love him. He's a good rapper. Twisted signed him when they started their own label. Okay, yeah, there we go. That old photo. she's like I'm all gray and old looking now. But yeah, I mean, G-Mo Ski will be on here eventually. He's a freaking amazing artist. I love the shit he does. He's so fucked up in the head. He reminds me of a black Chancy. Which is funny because I thought Chancy was black before I met him. The sound of his voice. I thought he was black.
The sound of his voice.
Hey, I've been told I got a black voice too, so you know it goes both ways.
No, yours is just deep. Like if anything, yours is just a little deeper than your average white guy. Chancy, just say something real quick, like in your normal voice, not no, like
don't put nothing on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I'd say Jeremy's the first person that's ever said that before. I've never heard that.
Yeah, you no, said, I don't hear it. I would guess almost anything but African-American or black, whichever way y'all prefer.
I know that's Jamie, too, because I fucking have heard her say that, but.
I mean, yeah, that's definitely Jamie, because you definitely said that before, like, on other pods, definitely.
But so those are my top five, and Weirdo was an amazing song. It reminded me of horrorcore music in a way, almost. Like the lyrics of it were horrorcore based, almost. Like, and Chris Webby's from Connecticut, so a lot of horrorcore rappers in Connecticut and New Hampshire area are trying to make it. So I'm sure he's known, and I'm sure he knows some of them, or performed with some of them at least.
Yeah, Probably.
But that's my top five.
Sir Chancy. Webby is a fucking lyricist, though, for sure.
Yeah, it's not. Yeah, his lyrics are not that bad at all, really. I did appreciate a lot of the lines he gave. Which, Chancy, what are your top five? Because I'm apparently they're gonna match up with mine. I'm thinking, but we'll see.
Webby. I'm sorry, I just couldn't. I heard that, and I was just like,
"You sure it wasn't Webby and not Ready?"
No, Webby. No, that's what he said. He said his last name.
Okay, like, my bad. For some reason, I thought you weren't saying Webby. I was like, "Are you sure he's not saying, you know, Webby?" Because I mean, he does that a lot in his songs.
I know. I've noticed, and I was. I noticed. Like, I was just like, "Yeah, I'm not ready for this. I thought I was ready, but I am not prepared." And my top five. I had a lot of problems with this album. I really did.
I got a lot of problems with you people, and you're going to hear about it.
You're going to fucking listen to my goddamn opinion.
Pulling some Frank Costanza shit.
Fuck Bill Burr. I watched his new stand-up special today. Webby
Wednesday.
The actual first song that I truly enjoy off of this album, and I think it might even be the only song that I truly, authentically enjoy.
Wow.
University of Life.
That's a good song. I do like University of Life.
The only reason I like that song was because the chick that comes in and sings after him had an amazing voice. It was amazing.
Oh, Justina Valentina, whatever the name was?
Yep. Yeah, that's her. That's her.
Because I Wikipedia'd her because I knew I've heard her before and she's been on some other songs I know, but.
Bro.
I don't know. I expect more. I don't know.
You expect what more do you expect?
I don't know.
What more do you? What?
Success. You know. Sell something? I don't know.
Yeah, all right. Are you worth $2 million?
No, but
then he's worth
$2 million in Connecticut ain't shit.
Dude, Vince McMahon lives in fucking Connecticut. You telling me he ain't worth shit?
That's what I'm saying, though. $2 million ain't shit in fucking Connecticut, dude. That's what I said.
Yeah,
haters will hate. I mean, haters will hate. You know you made it when you got haters. Just saying.
I actually did like
Chances, that's true.
More. Yeah, I did like Freddy's more. I shouldn't say I liked it more. It was easier for me to digest. I enjoyed his leaning into the controversy.
In case Q doesn't know, because I know Q knows what album Freddy had, but Jamie brought Slipknot Volume 3. So this is an Iowan who rather listen to Tom McDonald than Slipknot.
The third album, yes, absolutely. But the three before that,
I mean,
would absolutely listen.
I'm not a Slipknot fan, so I would probably have to listen to Tom McDonald.
Fair.
But don't get me wrong, they put on a good show. I've been to one of their shows for sure. They put on a good show, but it's just not my kind of music.
I wish I'd have known that ahead of time. I'd have found something you just fucking you couldn't. I almost, dude. Just wait for my other top five for.
If you didn't, you could have picked almost anything but country, and I would have listened to it. If you'd have picked country, I wouldn't have gave it a listen. I wouldn't even cared. I'd been like, no.
Hey, he follows my rules.
I mean, I respect everybody's.
Hey, if Juggalos are gangbangers, country music fans are sister fisters. It's a meme that goes around. It's a meme I've seen around Facebook. I love that meme.
There's a meme I saw on Facebook where it was saying like, trucks be driving themselves now. Country songs will be about how their truck is leaving them or some bullshit. Right. Now it's just like, oh my god, that's so funny.
That's awesome. I also enjoyed Nightcrawler. Right, that's facts.
That's fact as fuck.
Yes. After University of Life came Nightcrawler and Campfire.
I didn't like Campfire. I just couldn't get into that.
I mean,
I feel like it was a little too slow for your liking, Jeremy.
Possible. I mean, then again, we were supposed to do this last night, so these songs are not fresh in my head like they were yet last night. But
apologies.
But I mean, University of Life, I did like. I just didn't.
I appreciated the postponement. Trust me.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure he was very happy when I told him Q couldn't do it last night.
Like, oh.
He's like, oh, I can actually listen a little bit.
I can lay down. I just want to lay down. I just want to lay down.
Go fuck yourself, dog.
No, from being sick, not from the Webby album.
Oh, fair enough.
Yeah, he's got some flu shit going on.
Yeah. I've been sick with the flu for the past couple days. But
I retract my statement. My bad.
It's all good.
I thought you were giving me shit for Webby.
No, I thought that was the case at first. I really did.
Oh, my God.
Like, is this truly this awful that I'm fucking, my body is rejecting it like a fucking donor organ? There was one song, I don't remember which one it is, but I was listening to it, trying to process what I'm hearing. And all of a sudden, I hear these tones like I'm in a fucking hearing test. And I'm like,
What was happening?
I'm not sure which song it is, but if you're listening to the song in the background, you hear like, beep. Like you hear single tones that come. I don't know. Like it's not. There appears to be a rhythm to it, but it's still like I'm sitting here listening to this shit, and all of a sudden it's like I hear a tone, and I fucking raise my hand because it's like a hearing test.
You click a button, you don't raise your hand.
Oh, well, in my school, we didn't have buttons. We had too many hooligans that would cut the fucking wires. So it was when you hear the shit, raise your hand.
Jesus.
Yes, Jamie. Hearing aids. Not a sponsor.
Not sponsored, but could be.
Yeah, right. I have one song left, and I saved it for the last because if it didn't go on my list, it would have been the first honorable mention I would actually give. Chris Webby.
I'm surprised there's an honorable mention you'd even give.
No. It made the list. Everything else was on its own. Maybe just trip. You all right? Cool.
What happened?
My old lady tripped on her way through the door. She went to... No, thank you. She was going to offer me a blanket. Miracle ear. Yes. Well, I need that. I'm deaf as fuck. I'm so deaf. Like, I can't
hear shit. My wife says I am, but I just have very selective hearing.
I just have the ability to ignore with, like, beyond any other ability to ignore. It's just weird.
I wish I had that. I only have, like, 40% of one ear left and then, like, 50% of the other ear. I grew up, blowing shit up out on the farm. My grandpa had a federal fire alarms license and a loading station, so he'd make a bunch of crazy shit, and we'd go down to the pond and light it, throw it out the pond. But Friend Like Me, I really liked that one because of the Latarius Milton, I think this is Martin, I forgot what his last name was, because he's talking about the hood rat shit. And I remember seeing that video, like seeing the news thing when he's like, I just wanted to do hood rat shit with my friends. So he steals his grandma's car.
So the songs that you like from the album are because of his features, not because of him.
Yeah, basically. I mean, like I said, there was a lot of feeling that I had that, like, Twist Again, Dazed and Confused.
Like, yeah, how did those not make your list? Like, those are definitely by far some of the best ones on there.
I kicked them out, man. Fucking, I was like, listen, if you're going to put a fucking pair, like, when you fucking put a parentheses to avoid fucking copyright fucking infringement. What? Twist Again is fucking a Chuck Berry song, dude.
I know what it is. I know what it is. You don't gotta tell me.
I'm sorry.
Wait, you don't think I pay attention?
Well, you did say you have an unparalleled ability to ignore.
What? You're right. But I'm saying, like, I'm definitely listening here, you know? I mean, like, what?
I'll be listening. You tell me to shut the fuck up. I'll be quiet. When you leave, I'll be talking again.
It takes Freddie a few times telling you that to get you to shut up.
Oh, for sure. But then again, you know.
Herding cats and all that.
Oh, I'll go all over the room. I mean,
you know, I really wish Chancy would have went first, because so we could end this on a positive note.
What? I did
that last weekend, Freddy.
Right? I think my problem with it is when Webby first came on the scene, like, as anything with I Love College and all the shit that, you know, it may not even be, like, it may not really even be his first shit, but it was, like, the first time I ever heard of him.
No, that's, like, legitimately, like, some of his first shit. Like, it's obviously not, like, when he was writing, like, as a kid, but I'm saying, like, since he actually got into college and kind of got into, you know, rap and stuff like that, yeah, that was, like, his first, like, published stuff. I'm damn near positive. I haven't been able to find anything earlier, put it that way.
Yeah. And then also at the time, there was that Friday song that came out, and I wanted to fucking pull my fucking eyeballs out of my head. That pop song, Friday. I don't know. I don't know who does it. All I know is that...
Wait a minute. You mean the... No. I'm confusing that with a different song. I was going to say...
It's a pop song, and it's garbage.
I was going to say Justin Bieber. I was going to say, Bieber?
It's not Bieber. It's a girl. It's a chick.
She has, like, it's not Bieber?
I'm certain.
Yes, Chris Webby did get ripped a new one in the 2000s bracket, as well as a lot of other good music, though.
However, though, he made it further than I ever thought. I didn't think he was going to make it out of the first round, personally.
Oh, Chancy! Star Wars made it out of the first round for the first time today.
No fucking way.
Because Freddie owed me that favor from the wrestling episode.
Yeah, Freddie turned his back on the crew.
On the crew.
He went to the dark side. Lightning hands and all, but all right. So that's your top five for that's all of our top fives for QCD. So we're gonna go to Chancy CD next because I want to hear
really done mine last.
Oh no, I want to hear Q's rebuttal on Biggie. We'll save mine for last because I think it's gonna have the funniest comments.
Yeah.
You guys saved the most fucked up shit for last, dude.
Yeah.
But so. Chancy, give us why you chose this album and why it's so important to you.
I was a kid, man. Like, when fucking Juicy first hit, you know, MTV and the radio and all that shit. Like, I was...
See, now, which album was it, though? You didn't say which album
Ready
it was.
Ready to Die.
I just wanted to make sure everybody got that.
Oh, yeah. His first one, Ready to Die.
It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Salt and pepper and heavy D up in the limousine. Hanging pictures on my wall. Every Saturday, rap attack, Mr. Magic, Molly Mall. I let my tape rock till my tape pop. Smoking weed and bamboo, sipping on private stock. Way back when I had the red and black lumberjack with the hat to match. Remember rapping Duke? The ha. You never thought that hip hop would take it this far. Now I'm in the limelight because I rhyme tight.
Yeah, it wasn't a good one with the best song ever, Hypnotize, on it, but.
Fair enough. You know, each their choice. I mean, if I was gonna pick a Webby album for one song, it wouldn't have been this album.
Yeah, I get that. But you can continue, Sir Chance, a lot.
The first time I heard not just the intro to Juicy, but just like the song itself, like I was just like, what the fuck is this? It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Like, I was like, I don't know what Word Up magazine is, but this sounds fucking awesome.
I used to see it in the little bodegas.
Yeah. You know, middle of Iowa, you got to go looking for that shit. Especially back then.
Yeah.
I just loved it really caused me to look in, like, try and look into more, which led me to the album. And then Big Papa dropped, like, not even that long after that. And then it went a whole other level, because it's like, what the fuck? Oh, dude. I can't even describe how, like, it's like trying to encapsulate an emotion and fucking hear. This is what it means. It was a life-altering event for me. Kind of like the first time I ever heard heavy metal. Like, I was just like, what the fuck is this?
It's like the first time you see a titty.
Yes. Yeah, it's quite similar.
All right, well, I'll give my review next, because it's going to be short and sweet, because Biggie Smalls is one of those rappers I respect for what he did. He died way too young, and he should have fucking still be doing rap to this day and producing other artists, because I would love to see who he brought up. But I like Biggie to some degrees. I like some of his songs. Same as Tupac. I'm not a big Tupac fan either. I'm pretty sure I like more Biggie songs than Tupac's, but just the way it goes. And my top five are pretty easy to pick, because I knew what three of them were before I even freaking turned on the CD. So
I liked both of them equally. Like, to say that one's better than the other is like, it's like saying water's not as good as Kool-Aid. Everybody loves Kool-Aid.
Not everybody loves water.
Yeah. Facts. I'm one of them.
Because water sucks. It really, really sucks. Yes, water sucks.
Oh yeah, I'll drink water only if I have to, or if I'm like hiking or some shit and I'm about to die. But other than that, yeah, I ain't drinking water unless it has Kool-Aid mix in it or Hawaiian Punch mix, which I have. But
nice.
That's what I'm drinking right now, because I had told my wife I'd stop drinking. So
hey, that's cool, man.
No, it's
I
not.
Respect that.
No, it's not.
I don't drink. So I mean,
I know you and Freddie are the sober fishes, but
what do you mean? Oh, Freddie, right? Yeah, the teetotaler.
Well, I call bullshit on Freddie, by the way.
Well, yeah. we got him. We got him to do a couple shots when he was
That's
on our
true.
Show.
He did. That is very true.
That is very true. But I still call bullshit. I can take a shot and feel like it doesn't faze me. I mean, because it doesn't. But I'm just stating, like, I call bullshit.
When I did drink, because there was a period when I did drink, I would drink like bourbon, good bourbon, not whatever I could get my hands on.
Bourbon and Sprite?
Just bourbon.
Oh, just bourbon straight, man.
Just
a good good bourbon. You don't need nothing else besides maybe an ice cube.
I'm saying, all we have here in fucking this town is cheap-ass bourbon. So, I mean, you got me so solid. It's nasty.
That's awful. I'm sorry about that.
Facts.
What the hell?
That's part of the reason why I don't drink. I just don't like tree swings. Dead Nazis. It's just... That's like, it's bourbon and Rumple Mints. Those are the two things that I drank specifically. Because you could get like a bunch of Rumple Mints in an ice, like on the rocks, and let the ice melt while you drink a beer or whatever, if that's your thing. I can't drink beer. I'm allergic. Weirdest shit ever. I can drink liquor, but I cannot drink beer. If I have more than two beers, I get sick. And immediately go into hangover symptoms for like at least 3 days, and I don't know why.
All right, I think it's time for Q to give his review of Biggie, because I'm dying to hear it.
I mean, it's not like, I don't know, I'm just more of a West Coast person, I suppose. I mean, I was born in California. I mean, I wasn't necessarily raised there, but I lived there for about 8 years. You know what I mean? So, I mean, I guess I just have that West Coast vibe. I don't know exactly. No, I'm not saying Biggie was a bad artist. I'm just not a fan of Biggie, just kind of as you're not a fan of Tupac.
What?
Yeah, I mean,
Who's not a fan of Tupac?
I am.
Are you
not...
You don't listen. You're looking at shit, man.
I'm deaf, man. Like, fuck.
Hearing aid. That's awesome. It could be.
I stayed that I'm not a big fan of either. But I will.
Oh, listen. Yeah.
There's more Biggie songs I like than Tupac songs. That's for damn sure.
See, and I'm on the opposite side of that. I like more Tupac songs, and I know more Tupac songs than I do Biggie.
It's like Coke and Pepsi, motherfucker.
There's a clear difference. There's a clear difference.
I prefer Coke.
I'm more of a Pepsi guy.
I drank Pepsi myself. I used to drink Coke, and then...
I mean, my all-time favorite is Dr. Pepper, but that wasn't in the choices.
Dude,
so.
When I drank caffeinated soda, dude, I drank Dr. Pepper and Pepsi like it was going out of fucking style.
Same. But no, freaking... I love whatever's on sale. That when I used to drink soda, it was whatever's on sale. Whatever's on sale that week, I'm buying it. Whatever has a better deal, if it's Coke or Pepsi, I'm buying that one. But or if it's Dr. Pepper orange soda, I'm happy. But all right. So let's go with Chancey's top five since it's his album.
Okay. I'll go from my least favorite to my favorite.
That's where we usually do it.
Should be apparently obvious as to like my favorite. Number five I chose was Friend of Mine. And the reason I did it was because
Dude, your CD.
Yeah.
Oh, that is on there. You're right.
Motherfucker. I was like, what? I was like, did I read the wrong list?
But Chris Webby had a fucking very similar song title. So.
Yeah, Friend Like Me. That's exactly how it went down. Like I was like, oh shit. That's cool. And I was like, let's see what this one is. That's been a while. I forgot about this one. And I was like, oh. And I was like, all right. Yeah, Friend of Mine. And then Who Shot You, obviously. Gimme the Loot, number three. That's a fucking... The only thing better than Gimme the Loot is Bullshit Party. I wished... The only thing that would have made this better if, like, the Max and the Dons was on this album. I fucking love that song. That was fucking bad. Number two was Big Papa, obviously, because, you know, it's fucking iconic. And then number one is definitely Juicy. Just fucking...
What was your last one? I didn't hear you, sorry.
Oh, my favorite one is Juicy.
Juicy?
Yeah. I mean, it's just fucking... Got the bob, man. You just sit there, you put it on. Just like, it was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine, and all you just chick, you just chilling. Get your head bobbing. Yeah. All right, so what's up? Okay, let's see what's up. Let's take it to the next. Yeah, I am astounded. I am absolutely astounded to hear that anybody would say they don't like either Tupac. I mean, I understand somebody saying they like one more than the other. That's, yeah. I mean, that's.
I didn't say I didn't like Biggie. I just said I wasn't a big fan.
No, I know. I was talking about old Jeremy. He was like, I'm not a big fan of either. And I was like,
right.
Wait.
But I do respect their classics. I mean, I grew up with their classics playing on the radio and shit, playing in movies, so I know them. Right. But.
Yeah.
Can anybody tell me why that was edited real quick?
What was edited?
The album.
I sent the wrong one.
Oh, and you didn't think to send me the right one.
Well, I figured,
so I listened to some edited bullshit?
You know
how bad that was? Hearing every fucking, every time, you know, like, it's just like, what the fuck?
Well, the funny thing is, I figured you would do the same thing I did as soon as you heard the first freaking bleeped out word, and you would go to Spotify and find the right one, because there's four fucking versions of this CD on Spotify for some reason.
I was driving, so I really didn't have time to look through Spotify to find the right one.
I was driving too, and I still did it.
You're more skilled than I am, sir.
I live in a car, basically, for work, so yeah.
That's your fault.
But not soon. I won't be. Soon I'll be home all day, so I can watch movies more
and do more podcasts. Right?
Not during the day when I'm working. I have to be able to take phone calls. But
fair enough.
And be in Zoom meetings. So yeah. But all right. That was all yours, Chancy. Right? I believe.
Yes.
With Juicy.
honorable mentions, literally the rest of the album.
Like, you're pulling the Jeremy. You're out pulling on a fucking Jeremy.
Gladly. That might be the first time or only time I said it.
Nah, I'm pretty sure you did the same thing with, I want to say DFD, but I'm not sure.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, represent DFD.
Gotta love that dog fashion disco, but...
Oh, dude, I'm looking at their album right now. Buddy Wine got it for me, either for my birthday or for Christmas. And I was like, oh, dude, I have tips.
All right, who's dinging?
Yeah,
it's somebody in the other room.
It's my other podcast group. When you're part of the when you're masturbating, they send you a lot of messages.
Fair enough. So, wait, shouldn't they be sending you less messages?
Well, Q, since you're the guest, you give your top five for Chancy CD next.
All right, my top five from least to best was probably in the order of Ready to Die, Everyday Struggle, Give Me That Loot, Respect, and then, of course, Big Papa. Got to have that as the top. I mean, that's just an iconic song.
It is iconic. Absolutely.
Wow. I am actually fucking amazed because my top five is almost completely different from, like, the obvious ones. Aside from the obvious, like, two, it's completely different from your guys, completely. But my two honorable mentions for the CD are Everyday Struggle and The What, because those were some banging-ass tracks. But they couldn't make the top five. They fucking couldn't. Number five, I Can Almost See, is my wedding song.
Fuck off.
And it's Me and My Bitch.
I knew it.
As soon as
the opening line, I was like, Jesus, here it comes.
Because that song's about love and love dying, and like, well, not love dying, but the one you love dying. And
it's, like, wait a minute.
It's touching. It's touching in a way. Like, it's definitely touching. But, and number four is, of course, my style as well. And I never knew Biggie had a song like this, but it's definitely Suicidal Thoughts. Because that song was like, I was like, this is Biggie? Holy fuck. I didn't think he went like dark like that, like hardcore shit. I mean, that's basically Dark Half's whole fucking idea. But number three, of course, is Juicy. It has to be. Even though I do like Psychopathic Writer's Scrimping Grits or Scrimps and Juice lyrics a little better because they're funnier. But sipping on Scrimps and Juice. But yeah. And number two, of course, is Big Papa. Because I fell in love with that song watching the best Keanu Reeves movie, Hardball.
Oh, God.
And I forget the little black kid's name, but when he died and, like, they played that song, like, everybody tears up at that point because it's like he used to bang that song all day long. Like, that little kid loved that song, and it's just it's a good song. I mean, Big Papa has always been a good song, and I've used that line many times throughout college and everything else as well. But
how'd that work out for you?
Number one, of course. I didn't hear what you said, even Q.
Oh, I said, how'd that work out for you?
I went to a mostly black college, so yeah, it went pretty well.
Fair enough.
But number one was One More Chance. And because I listened to the CD 2 days ago, I don't remember why it's my number one, but there had to be a good reason. And I'm pretty sure it was because it was lyrically just an amazing song. If I'm remembering it
right. Apologies again.
Oh, you don't have to apologize, dude.
I'm pretty sure Chancy would have dropped out last night if you didn't. So
I was thinking about it, dude. I was like, okay, if they don't say nothing to me, I'm gonna suck it up. We're gonna fucking do this with a bucket in my lap. I don't give a fuck. I'll just hit the mic. Just fucking heave. Y'all can just have it on live. Fucking live. How's that for content, motherfuckers?
So, yeah,
motherfucker.
As I said, my top five were completely different than yours, guys, except for the two obvious ones that everybody has in their top five. Right. So I don't think Q had Big Papa.
I had Big Papa. I didn't have Juice.
Okay, yeah, I knew it was one, you're that or vice versa, but
I will give that the honorable mention, though. There we go.
Yeah, I mean, you got it. It's Juice.
It is a good song.
But, so, my CD I picked, which I picked because Q happened to say when he was listening to my music for my birthday bracket that he didn't.
Oh, bro.
That he then wasn't on, which Scum was not. Scum was even on my birthday bracket because I knew he wouldn't make it far if I did, and I had to know my audience, so I picked wisely.
You picked no. Okay, who won that bracket, by the way?
On the music side, I think Cradle of Filth won it, but
how did Boston not win that side?
3-6 Mafia got beat everybody out because everybody kept picking 3-6 Mafia except me.
3-6 Mafia is fucking good.
They were. And they had a few bumping songs. That was about it.
What?
And they were only good because of one person.
Their first four CDs are amazing.
I need to know who.
Amazingly in the Trash Can. Yeah, that's where they belong.
What?
You heard me.
Who's this one person that you say is the reason that 3-6 Mafia was...
I'm guessing it's the person you'd like to do the voice of, Chancy.
Well, I just wanted to hear, because there's a lot of people in this group, all right? Because are we talking about the original, you know?
Like, the original three.
Oh, like, so, like, Project Pat?
Yes, them, yeah.
Juicy J and,
DJ Paul.
DJ Paul, thank
you. Yeah, they were only good because of Juicy. If Juicy J was not there, they would not have been shit.
See, I like them better actually when they came. I like them better when they came back as Dumb Mafia 6 and Juicy wasn't involved.
I didn't even bother to give that a tune because there's stuff prior to that, aside from a few good decent songs, are trash.
Oh no! So, their first four albums where they wanted to be like ICP were fucking amazing.
Changed my mind. I said it. Changed my mind.
Next time you're on the show,
I would have known. If I would have known that, I would have picked like As the Smoke Clears or some shit. Like,
yeah, seriously, when the smoke clears or Chapter 3, this is the end. Like, they're both fucking incredible.
Choices, fucking choices.
You know, there's only one reason why you guys would do this, because you're both bastards like myself.
Well, I suppose you could say that.
Obviously.
I mean,
I think I might be the biggest 3-6 Mafia fan out of the three of us, and I'm astounded
at this. Dude. I debate that fucking claim right there.
I'm not in this one.
I mean, I'm not going to argue against it.
If you like past their fourth CD when they started becoming like MTV popular and shit, then maybe, because I hate that phase they were in when they were popular. But
they had to do something.
And then they kicked Lord Infamous out, and that's just a whole nother fucking upset. Because Lord Infamous was the best one of them, in my opinion. And his solo shit is amazing.
Lord Infamous was a great fucking artist.
But anyway, the reason we're talking about 3-6 Mafia to begin with is because of my birthday bracket, which if Q actually was on it, maybe they wouldn't have won. But,
hey, it's not my fault. For some reason, there was some weird background bullshit. I don't hear it. Do you guys hear it this time?
No, maybe it was your computer. I don't know. I don't know what the fuck it was.
That yeah, same phone, bro. I don't know what the hell was going on.
That's why we don't use Anchor anymore. Because Anchor does that sometimes. So, but if you're there, maybe they would have won because Freddie Harvey and Chancy voted for 3-6 every chance they got. Literally. But I mean, Scum wasn't on there because I knew my audience, and even putting Dark Half on there was just I just wanted people to hear Dark Half. That's the only reason I put them on, because I knew they weren't going to make it past the first round. But I did love when Harvey sent me the message saying, right now, I'm wearing someone's intestines as a necklace. I was like, oh, you're listening to Dark Half. And the fact that I know those lyrics off the top of my head like that. But Scum is an amazing artist who's been around since like 2003, 4. He came over from Russia in the late 90s, I believe, to America to rap. And him and a bunch of other hardcore artists that we'll get into eventually later were all signed to one company. And then that company dissolved because they're trying to do something like mainstream with hardcore, and it just didn't work. So they broke off into two different record labels, and two of them made their own record labels and got everybody else to join up with them. And Scum's record label, Serial Killing Records, is freaking amazing. I love his record label. I love the artist on it, such as Dark Half, and also such as Smalls One, which we'll get into eventually too, and a few others. But Scum is very good music when you are angry and you hate the world. That's what it's good for, is when you just have a bad day at work and you need to blast something on your way home to get over it.
That's why you, okay, so you're having a bad day at work, so you listen to angry music.
It calms me.
To me, that just seems to do, that would do the opposite. That'd make me more angry. That'd give me more amped up to, like, go do something about it.
But it's not just angry music. It's, I'm going to kill this motherfucker because he pissed me off music.
Yeah, and music is influencing, bro.
No, don't tell me you're one of those fools who thinks that Marilyn Manson caused Columbine.
No, but I feel like Eminem caused a lot of things.
Yeah, rap to go bad, but I mean, besides that.
Fuck, he was the best thing to happen to rap.
Bullshit. He wasn't even the best rapper to come out of Detroit.
He's the biggest one, so yes, that does make him the best one.
I don't know, does he have his own festival every year where thousands upon thousands of people go for a weekend?
He doesn't like people, so no, he does not.
But yeah, that's why I picked Scum, and this CD...
No rebuttal. Just, all right, we're going back to my my pick here.
I don't want the show to go on all night. I got
fair enough,
and I got to sleep at some point. So
don't we all?
But this CD came out right when I got into Scum for the first time, really. Because, but I mean, Scum was just an amazing artist when I got into him. I randomly started hearing him on other artist tracks that of people I like, and. He was good always, so I'm like, all right, I gotta check this motherfucker out. This CD came out, and then I believe it was 2 years later, I met him live at a concert he was headlining. And it was it was a small venue, like maybe 20 people there, because it was a bunch of hardcore rappers in Worcester. So, I mean, I expected more
people. So, no fan base?
Oh, he has a pretty big fan base, actually, but a lot of it's out west where he's from. But
well, right, no, I was saying, like, over where he was doing the concert at, there's not a big fan base. That's what I said.
Well, I mean, Worcester technically is full of juggalos, so Worcester usually is pretty big, but not all juggalos like hardcore is dark as Scum. But I can't judge what they do. But there are a lot of familiar faces at all concerts in Worcester of hardcore artists, and those are the ones that came. So I actually got to meet the man. I got to smoke cigarettes and joints with him all night, and I got to fucking do Jaeger bombs with him. Like, it was a fun time. Like, I bought him a fucking Jaeger bomb because of how much he helped my life. So, and I got to talk to him for so long about the rap industry and everything else outside while smoking and shit. While all the openers I didn't care about were performing. But he's just an amazing man. Like, my cousin was with me and he's not into this genre at all, but he met him and he's like, he's such a nice guy. And then he got up on stage and he heard some of the lyrics. He's like, I'm gonna go sit at the bar. But, my cousin's not like me that way, at least. But
so see, now he's like a guy. Like, okay, so now, honestly, I haven't met him. I haven't read up on him, or you know, any of the sort. I just listened to, you know, the one album that I was given, and he's somebody I would not want to meet in a dark alley. I'm scared of what he's gonna do to my body after he slits my throat and watches the blood fill up, and you know, in his bathtub.
Yeah, I mean, well. But the funny thing is, he is nothing like that in real life. That's just him
a weird fucking thought process then, and that's still scary when you put it to work.
Well, put it this way. You watch horror movies. Do you think the director has a sick fucking mind, or is he just doing it for entertainment purposes?
I feel like there's a lot of horror movies that are based off of like little kids' dreams.
Well, it might be director's. Might be the director's kid's dreams. Who knows?
Wouldn't that be more of a writer?
Yeah, that'd be the writer, actually. But depends if it's the same person or not. Sometimes it is with horror movies.
Sometimes it is, yep.
But,
and, you know, either way, they just could have a really sick, demented mind. And it's just weird.
I mean, you've seen the rap I've written. You could tell this, and I wrote a lot of that rap before I even heard of Scum. So he ain't the only one out there that thinks of this type of shit. Just saying, but
I mean, fair enough. Yeah, I mean, I had a friend a while back ago. He was like really big into screamo music. Fucking hate it. Can't stand screamo music.
Oh, same.
Cannot stand that shit. Like, it's a toss up if I'd rather listen to screamo or country, and that's saying something. I hate country.
Yeah, I can.
But
I wouldn't listen either. You couldn't make me.
But yeah, I mean, like, like, I read some of his lyrics and shit that he had written down, and it was just like, bro, I'm questioning our friendship right now. Like, what the fuck are you writing about? Like, I was almost scared.
Yeah, I mean, when people hear, like, when my wife first heard some of my music, she was like, I like this, but what the fuck is wrong with these people? I mean, she doesn't get into the hardcore rap as much as I do, but she likes horror movies, so she sees the entertainment purposes of it. But, Chancy? Well, first of all, we should also point out that anybody that didn't hear this early in the episode, Quentin thought this was Chancy's CD to begin with.
100%. It had Chancy written all the fuck over it, man.
I'd have made so much money off of you. You'd have paid me like a rube. I'd have been like, yeah.
I'm just stating. Like,
his circus folk past makes him good at that, but...
How dare you for being prejudiced, sir?
Prejudiced?
It's truth.
I don't know.
I'm not saying it's, you know... I didn't say you were wrong, but... it was prejudicial bias. You were like, oh, this is fucking Chancy all day, twice on Sunday.
Well, based on the other pick, yes, 100%. Like... I can't tell you how many times I've heard Jeremy say the whole Big Papa line, you know, like, you know, during other pods and stuff. So I'm just stating that seemed like a very logical Jeremy pick. And then you're out there in fucking God knows what universe. So skull fucking might be okay in your eyes.
I mean, the only difference that I would have on this is that she'd have to actually have the eye removed first. Like, I'm not taking the eye out and then fucking. That's not what I'm doing. Like, if she popped the glass eye out and I stuck the tip in to see how it felt, like, that's a whole ass other thing.
Take two. Cut.
And that right there was our that's the opener. That's the opener.
Oh my god.
That's the fucking opener right there. Oh my god, yeah.
I've been waiting. I was like, I'm going to think of something fucking just god-awful. And I was like, you know what? Just the tips.
I feel like you wing it. I feel like you don't even think this shit out. You just wing it.
Sometimes you're quite right. But sometimes I actually purposefully drag it
like your dick reaching through glass?
Yep. Miles of broken glass. Miles.
Mine won't reach the ground, and I'm not crawling, so...
For Christina Ricci, he'll fucking crawl.
Gladly.
I mean, I might do the same thing for some certain actresses too. I mean, some certain BBW actresses, but we won't go into that now. That's for a future episode of The Sip List. But
oh god.
Oh, what did you hear? The Hall, superhero Hall Pass one.
I don't even want to get into it.
DeAndre was supposed to get into it like fucking 3 days, like a week ago about it, and he still hasn't gotten into it yet on my chat with him, but he had so much shit to say, he said, then he just forgot about it, but I gotta ask him what the fuck he had to say about it, because I know it's gonna be funny, but I had very good choices for my mind, but Chancy, why don't you give your review of my CD, because I'm dying to hear it.
Dude, just when I thought things could not get worse. Because I was like, all right, I'm going to get Q's out of the way first. Just fucking right out the bang. I'm going to fucking just like a bolt to the brain, fucking get Q's fucking out of the way. Because I assumed, see, I pulled the same fucking mistake you did. I assumed that it was going to be something else. And it starts to play. And I start hearing the lyrics and I'm like, did I just hear this motherfucker say this right? I rewound it. I gave it the tap back. Like, I was like, because I do YouTube music, so I gave it the tap back. I was like, what the fuck is this shit? And it's like, I'm not going to lie, bro. I didn't even make it through the whole album. I didn't. I got five and got the fuck out of Dodge. Like, I was like, nah, fam. Like, as of the postponement, I only had one song from the album. And that was like, I got to fucking pick something.
And here I am thinking you would love the CD because it fit your dark sense of humor.
You know, I was listening the whole time from QCD to your CD. I was like, wait a minute. Like, how am I having the most, like, popular artist out of the three of us? Like, how am I bringing the most mainstream album to this show? Like, this should never happen. Like, yeah, I mean, Jeremy, your tastes are quite eclectic.
I have to ask, whose did you like to listen to better?
Oh, fuck you.
Well, actually, Q asked you which album you like better. He's putting you between a rock and a saw blade, basically.
Basically. Saw blade and fucking Himalayan sand.
So, who's the rock and who's the saw blade?
Well, I mean,
I couldn't even tell you.
Which actually, I fucked this up earlier. Lyrical Snuff Productions, which is Scum's record label, actually, the logo is a saw blade.
And they would you rather be cut to pieces or just smashed up real quick?
Or it's cut in half really fast and it kills you pretty much on impact.
Yeah, I was going to say, I mean, I'll be dead either way, so it's fine. As long as I'm dead, I don't care. Take the meat suit, fucking wear it.
So then you're not picking which one?
No, because they're both.
See, rich. I feel like he doesn't want to give me the satisfaction.
Mostly. I refuse to give you satisfaction, sir.
Well, I would hope so.
That's on a professional level.
We're live on Facebook, so no one needs to get satisfaction here. But we'll be taking off the air like fucking many Super Bowl halftime shows. But.
That the suspect was down.
Look on my shoulder and the pigs are right behind me. The naked body riding shotgun with no head. They on my ass with flashing lights, they trying to blind me. Not knowing I'm packing a sort of shotgun full of lead. You golden badge motherfuckers came across a gold mine. Better make a quota for the month with one arrest. But first to run, I put this motherfucking gun up. Better have his vest cause I'ma blast him in the chest, yeah. I got more drugs in my possession than the Walgreens. I got an axe and got a mask when it's in my face. Was about to go to blood.
My top five from the CD, and yes, I do have four honorable mentions. I'm not pulling a Jeremy, but I do have four honorable mentions. The first one is I Don't Want to Hurt You.
But I do.
The second one is The Last Gorhekin, because I love that song because it's about being an underground rapper and like just surviving in it. I love Pigs, because that's the one music video that came out of this CD, and that video is just, it literally is them like wrapping around a fire with like a literal pig over the fire, but it's just amazing. Him and Insane Poetry also have their own rap duo called MMMFD, Make My Motherfucking Day. Okay. And they're pretty fucking good together in everything they do. So
Pigs was on my list, so
I figured it'd be on both of your lists, but and my last honorable mention is For the Fuck of It. Because Smalls One is on that song, and I love Smalls One when she does features on songs. She's such a good rapper. But my number five was Fuck Your Corpse, because I especially because of the one line at the end of the song, I had to kill her quick because rape's just wrong. So if you think about it, it's actually a very feministic thing for a man to say, because he's saying rape's wrong, but necrophilia isn't quite as bad.
Okay. There's just, I mean, like, you can't say, there's nothing you can say about that statement to make either one okay.
I mean, I'm not the one saying it, really, but
I'm stating, like, there's nothing you can say right there.
And I do
put a positive spin anywhere on that.
And plus, I actually thought Chancy would enjoy the opening to that song, where he, it's actually him going up to a woman and being like, I would really love to fuck your corpse. And like the way he says it, it's so funny. He's like, I just want to ask you something. Can I ask you something? And then at the end of the song, like his friend's like, well, what did she say? I mean, it's just, I love the ending and beginning of that song so much as well. Like, it's just hilarious. And plus, Scum's beats are always on fucking point. Like, his beats are amazing. I love his beats. Put the lyrics aside.
Did you seriously just say somebody would like the opening of a man walking up to a female and saying, I want to fuck your corpse?
Well, Chancy's sense of humor. I thought he'd like it.
That is not humorous. That is fucking, that is borderline, like, I don't even know a border. There's no border in this one. That's just fucked. To me, if I was that bitch, I'd be like, so you're going to kill me and then fuck me? Like, fuck.
I'd have been like, no, I'm going to fuck you and then I'm going to kill you.
Either way. I mean, that sounds better. Fuck. Shit. I can't even justify this. You guys are fucking ridiculous.
I honestly never thought the Q and I would agree on anything, let alone this album.
Well, there's also a Kung Fu Vampire album we'll get into eventually too. That has a song that's similar to this, and I love Kung Fu Vampire. But number four was Snuffumentary because I love the beat in that one. That beat is just, and I like that. I don't know, all the lyrics in it too are pretty good. And
that beat annoyed the fuck out of me.
I'll have to go back and listen to it.
Don't make your ears bleed.
And number three was Not Alike, because it's another song where he's talking about being an underground rapper and about people saying like they hate him all the time and stuff too. And he's just like, I don't give a fuck. Fuck you. Like, I'm gonna do me. You go die. Like, that's basically what he's saying. But I love that song. That song's amazing. And I think Chancy almost could guess by number two, because there's a certain feature on it that is someone we've had in the show multiple times.
My
number two is Devil.
Oh, shit.
Featuring Isham.
If I was gonna make a grab at anything, it would have been Isham. But
well, a lot of Detroit bitches have done what you just said, but but yeah, I mean, Isham and Q Strange. I love Isham, as everybody that listens to this show would know. And Q Strange is another good underground rapper. I really never listened to any of his albums straight out, but I've heard him on so many different songs that I respect his flow. But Devil is I love Devil. I love the line, you're not the devil, you're just doing the devil's work. Like, it's, that line's just perfect for my life. But
okay.
And number one has to be, because of another feature on it, one half of Dark Half, which that was a little tongue twister there for me. For a second, my mind started fucking up the words. But Gene Okult Shit, which he actually died a year or two after this album was put out, because he asphyxiated while he was on the ground, passed out from drinking at a party with the whole record label. So they all woke up and found their buddy and fellow artist dead, which sucked. I actually talked to Scum about that for like 10, 20 minutes that night, but because everybody thought he committed suicide. Like, that's what little bit of media coverage he had said was, like, he committed suicide. But Scum said, he's like, no, he was so happy that night having the time of his life. He's like, it was purely accidental. Like, he didn't want to kill himself. He loved his life. But Gene Okult Shit is the half of Dark Half that has the very melodic voice, like, the other guy in it, I wish we had the name of. He's the rapper mainly, and Gino just can like kind of sings along with it, but like in a rap flow kind of way, and it's perfect. Like, his voice, I just love. So that's why Scream's my number one, because anything with Gino on it, I'll fucking put as my number one, because Gino was an amazing voice and amazing fucking writer and everything else. We'll get into Dark Half Adventure in this show. Don't you worry, Chancy.
Okay.
He's gonna make your ears bleed.
I mean.
Just so you know, Jansy, you agreed to this.
I know. I'm okay with it.
I agreed to be on a show. I'm not permanent by any means. You are, though, and, well, I feel sorry for Ishii sometimes.
Hey, I heard some of the albums he's given me too. I'm like, what the fuck?
Oh, I'm sure. I am most definitely sure. I can't imagine if there was a third person on this thing that was permanent, they would have probably have quit. Like, I can't do this.
I mean, what was it? It was the blues one you gave me, and what was the other one you gave me? That fuck. Yeah, but there was another one that you gave me. I was like, what the fuck is this?
I don't remember. Because you griped so much about Sunhouse that I didn't even. I forgot the other one because you were bitching.
Oh yeah. Last week, Obsin.
Oh, yeah, Meshuggah.
Yeah, Meshuggah.
That's a great fucking album, dude. For sure.
And for Jamie, I'll say it the right way, Meshuggah. But yeah, so those are my top five. All right, Q, as the guest, I'm dying to hear your top five.
I'm going to give a little review first.
I thought you already did that earlier, but be my guest.
I don't remember doing that. I remember Chancy doing that.
I think
you went into it a little before Chancy did that thing, but
more than likely.
But please give it away.
God damn! What goes through your fucking head, bro?
Words don't affect me.
It's funny though, because you're like, "Oh, this is Chancy's pick."
Well, I mean, yeah. It, like I said, between the choices, that was the logical lineup. You're weird like that, Chancy.
I'm. It doesn't hurt my feelings. You got to be weird. You got to stay weird.
I'm not saying to her feelings. I'm just saying, but the album's bad. Just bad. Every song was about the same fucking shit. It was about killing, corpse fucking, skull fucking, blood being everywhere. Fucking the dude has problems. He needs to go see a psychiatrist and talk these feelings out before they become like footage.
It's funny because he's one of the coolest people I ever met in my life, actually, and one of the chillest. Like, I had some.
Fair enough. I'm only basing him off what I know from listening to this album because I knew nothing about him. I've never even heard of this dude before, and there's probably a reason for it.
If you're not in the horrorcore scene, it's not like.
I'm definitely not into that shit. Like, it's just, like, to me, it's, like, I see where the entertaining value could be. I just don't see it entertaining as myself because I listen to, like, I actually listen to the words, the lyrics, you know, the lines, the bars, you know, whatever you want to call them. And it's just fucking creepy, bro.
I'm not disagreeing with you.
It's just astoundingly creepy, and that's not my type of vibe, personally.
Yeah, when you get into Cradle of Filth in high school, you can kind of make your way over to horrorcore rap. Like, that's pretty easy.
I got into Cradle of Filth in high school, man, and
before my time.
Nah, they're still around.
We're the same age, motherfucker.
I'm 31.
All right, so you're 3 years younger. Big deal. They've been around since before I got into music, even.
Fair enough.
God, wait, I'm the older fucking statesman in this fucking.
Harvey
and I were.
You're Lord Greybush in this one. Harvey can be absent from that title for a night.
I wish Harvey had seen the movie because he'd find the reference funny.
Jamie getting tough talking Chancy here.
I am. These are facts.
Good English though.
Yeah, right.
but anyways, that's pretty much all I got to really say about the album in total. As far as my top five go.
Dying for this.
I just want you to know my top five are not because of the actual artists. It's because of the features. So this is really interesting because that's almost the same as Chancy's with mine.
Yeah, I'm literally nodding so fast. My head's not moving on the camera. My camera can't pick up how fast I'm nodding.
However, though, I did like the song Final Thoughts.
All right.
I don't remember who was featured on them. I didn't write those down. I probably should have, but I'm pretty sure Final Thoughts had a feature, and that's the only reason why I liked it.
I'm pretty sure. I got it right here because I'm pretty sure Final Thoughts. Oh, Playboy the Beast. Yeah, he's on a lot of songs I've heard too, and I do love him.
I'm saying he made that song. Like, I was about to skip it, and then he came on, and I was just like, all right, I can fuck with this. Also, I feel like the dude's voice with his music doesn't go. The reason why I think that is because it's like the one that I listened to on Spotify there. He was very hard to hear. Like, his music overtook his voice.
I could understand.
Because he was tired singing like this. And that shit, like, what in the fucking hell is that?
I could understand that.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, like, it was really hard. Like, he was really hard to understand. But, I mean, I have that ability. Like, I can listen to a song and pretty much pick up most of the lyrics. The only thing I really can't understand at all is screamo. Can't do it. I can't pick out a word. Not one.
I feel the same way, but
it's just like, what is he talking about? Why are you guys jamming out to this? What the fuck is this? It's just noise.
I need to get a question in to be clear, though. Are you talking about the specific genre that is known as screamo, or are you compiling all hard rock and heavy metal that you can?
No. Like, straight up screamo.
Awesome.
Like, actual screamo.
Because I thought we was going to have a problem for a second. I was like, listen, partner.
No. Those are completely different. I can understand them most of the time.
Like, I'll slap my pad down.
Yeah, because, like, I understand what he's saying, because I've had people say, like, Slipknot is screamo, and I'm like,
no, Slipknot's not screamo.
I'm like, no, they're fucking not. Shut your mouth. I'm like, Cradle of Filth isn't even screamo, really.
That one's borderline.
It's old school.
More borderline to black metal.
It's old school black metal or old school goth metal, depending what you
want. Fair enough. All right. I'll give it that. Pretty much same fucking thing. Anyways, another song that I liked was Fucked Up Sense of Humor.
I thought you'd like that one, actually.
And mainly just because we all have a fucked up sense of humor. We can all kind of relate to that in some way or another. And some of the lines in the song weren't all that bad. Paint It Red, I thought, was actually a decent song. I feel like I only liked it for the beat, though. I didn't really care about the lyrics so much.
Paint It Red. Was that even on the CD? Did you just pull a Chancy?
I'm pretty sure it was on the CD. That's what I listened to on Spotify.
I think it might be one of those songs that comes on after the CD ends.
Nah, it was towards the beginning of the CD.
Snuff isn't I like this. I'm not seeing it, and I'm looking at the CD right now.
What's the album called again? Because, like I said, all I did was click on your link.
Yeah, I know. But Paint It Red is a song by Scum, I'm pretty damn sure.
Then it was put on the Spotify list for some reason instead of the actual album it came on.
Paint It Red is a song by Insane Poetry, JP the Hustler, and Scum. And it's just a single. It's on a CD.
Okay, yeah, okay. It was on there, though.
I'm guessing it came on after the album, but that's just what I have a feeling of. But then again, I don't know. It could have been on. I don't know. It shouldn't be on there. I mean, it's on my version. There's only one version of this CD on Spotify, unlike Chancy CDs I got. Unlike my CDs that Chancy and Freddie fucked up. But
like that, all I did was click your link, and that's what it took me to. And I was listening through, and that's one of the songs. Because, I mean, I made sure to write down the titles because I would never remember them off the top of my fucking head. So.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely, it's a good song. I can't hate on it.
The other ones are, or the other one is Tired of Waiting. I kind of dug that song a little bit the way through it, more or less. I mean, like, I didn't care for it at first, but I started vibing to it, more or less, towards the end.
Tired of Waiting, that's...
Here we go again. I swear to God, this was on your Spotify list.
You know, after an album finishes on Spotify, and this is not a list, this is just literally an album I shared with you. But you know, at the end of albums on Spotify, they start playing similar music from the artist.
Yes, I am aware of this, but it was all on the same few. It was all on the same album.
Because that's on Scum Out with the Old. Like, that was a CD that came out like 2 years ago.
I've had it happen to me when you.
That's weird, then, because like I said, like Chancy, I didn't make it through the entire CD, like on Spotify. I made it through most of it, but definitely not through all the songs. And the songs that I picked were more towards the first part of the album.
Weird. That's so fucking. I swear to God, I want to. Wait a minute. Do you pay for Spotify or no?
No.
I think that might be what's going on here. Last week I was going to tell Chancy, like, I'm going to start sending you screenshots of the fucking album so you know what tracks are on it. Like, because, like,
Chancy. I have no idea what happened then.
That's weird, but I'm going to. Well, okay, definitely going to start sending a track list for the CD as well, then, just to make life easier for everybody. But,
like I said, I was just going off of what I listened to earlier today, so.
All right, let's hear what your number one is and see if it's actually on the CD.
I believe it was Off the Hinges or something like that. I'm trying to remember.
Off the Hinges?
Yeah.
That's actually funny because that's from the Scum CD I was trying to debate between with this one.
So like, that's not on the CD either. That's
even better.
No, that's not on the CD, but that is actually one of my favorite Scum songs, so that works.
Okay. I did find that one relatively funny, actually. I will admit that one was actually kind of good.
Because that's Scum, that's Dark Half, and that's Leaders of the Lost. So I mean,
yes, that does ring a bell.
That has three good fucking artists on it, so I do love that one. And Leaders of the Lost, it's hard to find though because I don't think they ever put out a CD. Actually, I think they just
probably not. Just maybe I think a few singles.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, Dark Half put out like two or three CDs before Gino died, then they've been putting out old stuff they recorded that they never released since he died, but kind of like Elvis and Tupac and all that, but
right.
But all right, Chancy, what are your top five? Because I'm dying to see if you did the same thing as Q.
No, I don't think so anyway.
I just clicked on what I was sent and that's what I heard.
Yeah, I know. I think it's a difference between being about having a paid Spotify account and not having a paid Spotify account.
Maybe. I have no idea.
Because I do pay for Spotify so I can use it for podcasts. But
Yeah. That makes sense. Yeah, I don't.
Anyways.
I think at some point when I was listening to this album, I pulled a Mick Foley and I gave myself the mandible claw until I passed out. And because I was listening to I can't even give you an order of like, oh, this is my fucking favorite out of all of these. Like, did we just bob our head at the same time? You, that's fun. the first song that I could put on the list that I was like, okay, like I said, I gotta fucking pick something, was Devil. I kind of like once I heard the first like the first lyric the song, I can't even like it's astounding. Like, I never thought I would agree with those like Tipper Gore and all those fucking horrible bastards that were trying to get stuff pushed out. Like, I could have done without the consistency. Like you said, it's like, it was hard for me to discern which song I was listening to because
The beats change so much every song, though. Like, it's
that's true. That's valid. I can't argue that.
See, now, I guess I really don't have a true say in this because they all sounded the fucking same to me. And apparently I was listening to a bunch of different songs from different albums, though.
Maybe why they sound the same, because, I mean, they may sound the same on different albums sometimes, but usually on an album, he keeps it different so that people can tell the difference.
Right. I'm still trying to figure out why, though, it was switching through albums or through songs of that artist, but different albums.
I can't explain this. Spotify, not a sponsor, but please be so we can fucking figure this out.
I mean, Chancy's list came up just fine.
So far.
So far. Here we
did. No. I'm saying, like, when I pulled up his Spotify.
Yeah.
On for his link or whatever.
Yeah.
All those songs were on there.
the white out clean version of Biggie? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I actually got the right album. I mean, as far as the actual album, rather than getting sucked into the fucking rando list. Because it happened to me as well, yeah. But, yeah. But no more Mr. Nice Guy.
That's a damn good song.
It was all right. I mean, I was like, Alice Cooper would probably be okay with them using that track title.
Oh, dude, Alice Cooper and Scum would be fucking drinking together. Like, they'd be having fun.
But I was like, God, fucking... Like, honestly, I can't tell you out of between Q's album and your album which one I actually would listen to again if I was asked to.
Like, if someone tied you up and put you in a room with speakers and said, these are your two options, which one would drive you insane the least amount, like, in like, the quickest, I guess?
Well, I mean, Jeremy's album did put me to sleep.
Didn't put you to sleep?
It did.
Oh, it did.
I'm certain that I fell asleep listening to this album because.
So it was boring to you.
Not so much boring. I think at some point exhaustion took over, and I just fucking went.
The brain trying to get all that in there for the first time, your brain kind of go.
Probably shut down. I'm not gonna lie.
Turned off. Click. I'm saving you from this right now. We're just going to exit the scene.
And you know what's funny is I listened to that album like 5 times over the last week to get my top 5.
Dissociate.
Like, I love Scum. I can listen to them all day. I have before at work.
The
looks your coworkers give you are amazing, though.
Oh, yeah. I could imagine.
Right, yeah. I can only picture their faces.
If I had to play something to make sure that nobody came up and spoke to me that day, I would pick that one. Pigs was number 4 for me. Lost Childhood.
I do like that song too, but it just didn't make my list.
And number 2 was just a victim. My number 1 was Devin because it was the first thing that I found that I could actually like pencil in without feeling like I had to do it.
You can actually pencil it in with lead instead of feeling like you were carving it into your arm with your own blood.
That doesn't make any sense, Q. How would you carve it into your arm with your own blood?
What I meant was, like, it was a reference to a Harry Potter. There's a pen that you write with your blood, and it carves it into your arm.
I got you.
I just didn't want to have to explain it fully like that. Well, but I mean, now that you made
like,
me...
If you'd have been like Harry Potter one, or the pen from fucking Order of the Phoenix, I think it is, isn't it?
It's Umbridge who makes him do it, so yeah.
Yeah, so like,
dude, that bitch, she is one of the, she's a bitch. Wait, I don't like her.
Wait till we get to Harry Potter characters on Bracket Bastards.
Oh, I can't wait. Valid. Can't fucking wait. I got that's so much to say.
So that's Chancy's top 5, I believe.
Yes.
All right. So you heard all 3 of our albums, you heard the reviews, and you heard the top 5, listeners. Next week, we're not going far to get our next guest. She's literally right down the couch. our next guest is the best looking bastard and the final bastard from Bracket Bastards. There she is. Yeah. Oh, come on, Chancy. The one time you don't do the yeah with me, but.
I'm sorry. I was spaced. I'm definitely not myself today. I'm sorry.
Next week, we have the best looking bastard, Quentin's wife, Jess, on it, on our show. And I went a lot. I had my CD picked out for her, and I went a lot easier on her than I did on Q, because I want her to actually be on the show and not be like, "Fuck you,
I'm not doing this."
My ears still hurt, just FYI.
Well, mine are hurting from whenever you talk right now because you're so fucking loud, so.
My bad.
My fault.
It's Chancy's fault more than anything, but my album for Jess is Savage Garden's Savage Garden.
Nice.
Which I almost was going to give to her because I didn't want to torture Chancy, but he actually told me he doesn't mind Savage Garden, so I was like, all right. And I'm going with my original idea for Jess because it's the one pop group I somewhat like.
Fuck yeah.
So.
They're a pop group? I thought they were like a band.
Well,
pop groups are bands, technically.
I mean, the Backstreet Boys and NSYNC was not a band. They didn't play anything. D12 is not a band. They don't play anything.
It literally says in the fucking song, you don't know the name of my band.
That's the joke. Wait for it. The joke.
So it's a pop. So next week is pop.
For you, Jess? Yes. Well, I can't promise what Chancy brought. I told him to take it easy on you, but Chancy likes to make it rough.
All right.
Going in raw.
No, that's Harvey. Harvey goes raw. Chancy's goes rough.
For my album, I'll make it. Van Halen's Van Halen.
All right.
Who are you picking?
Van Halen's Van Halen, the album. Van Halen.
Okay.
So, we're going from a week of metal to a week of rap to a week of pop.
And metal.
Van Halen is not really metal, I don't think. Maybe in the 70s they considered metal, but not anymore.
Yeah, I would agree with Jeremy.
They're classic rock, if anything. That's like my dad telling me that fucking Judas Priest is headbanging music nowadays. And I'm like, that's going to conclude our show this week because it is getting late and we're already at hour 40 minutes for this week. So, as always, we thank our guests for coming on and we will finish up with the Bastards next week. And then we have some more fun guests I've gathered to come on who. And the interest level is actually pretty damn high for this show. So
no shit.
I have a lot of podcast friends who have heard about this show and are dying to get on and give their albums into it. But
fuck yeah, dude. That's awesome.
And a couple rappers, possibly. I still got to talk to them. But
fuck yeah. I mean, you already got one right here, dog. What do you mean?
He wishes.
I said a rapper, not a whapper.
Oh, my bad. I didn't hear you right.
But we will see you next week. As always, we will ask our guests first, where can our listeners find you to hear more about you and possibly tell you Chris Webby sucks?
Wow.
Not that I think he sucks anymore, but
if that's what I'm about to give my socials just to get a bunch of bashing on Chris Webby, y'all got a storm coming. Because, well, I ain't letting that shit go down without a fight.
Where's that storm going to be found?
It can either be found on Facebook under Quentin Vandestroot or on the Instagram as your master bastard Q.
You heard him,
folks. That's actually really hard to say. I'm not going to lie.
You heard him, folks.
I was impressed.
You heard him, folks. Masturbator Q. But, and sorry, Freddie. My show, I'm not editing it out. But Chancy, what is your one social as always?
My Facebook. I don't fuck around with that fucking Twitter. I ain't gonna get on no Twitter.
What about the gram, dog? I gotta get the G. Come on.
Okay, he gets enough.
I ain't getting no goddamn G's.
He's already got a draw of fucking gram, so.
Give me the loot. I ain't gonna walk out with one G, but hell.
And I understand it's the I that just doesn't sound as entertaining.
Yeah.
Sounds like saying Apple. Like, the fuck?
And as listeners of this show do know, you can find everything I do on Paranormal, the New Normal Facebook group. All podcasts I do are there. Stop me from listening off like 5 minutes of podcast. But, and you can also find me on Twitter and the gram as @JuggaloBastard. And you can find me on Facebook as Jeremy Bryant as well. And you can find me on TikTok as Paranormal, the New Normal. Coming soon, Cryptic Crate unboxing videos, as Cryptic Crate will now be a sponsor of my show.
Cool.
Cool.
Yes. I've been making connections. But thank you all for listening, and we'll see you next week with whatever album Jess decides and the two we already mentioned. Have a good one.
Peace.
Say bye, Chancy.
Bye.